30 seconds to battle.
Should have seen that coming. Lights out for you.
Thank you very much, the Zyorian. We're gonna get straight into the game here as we already have some action coming down as they tried to jump the Bloodseer. Oh no! I thought Fable was gonna intro that one. You know, he got shy. Chickadella. No, I'm just kidding. I was definitely muted. But we did have some action coming. As the Bloodseeker ended up very nearly going down as Liquid tried to make a movement straight off the bat. Meanwhile, it looks like LeBron's going to be able to grab the bounty runes here. And yeah, it's going to be 2-for-2. It's all very boring. So that's going to give us a chance to get our takes on the game. I mean, personally, I like Spider Pig's draft here in game number two. Again, I think they're drafting very well. Whether they'll be able to follow up on a performance after game one, I'm not sure. But, you know, I'm just looking for a good game of Dota from these guys.
The next label play.
The next label play.
Really now? You should have seen that coming.
Oh, nice dagger. A skewer under the tower. The dagger's slowing down as well. Tiger losing a lot of HP down the bottom lane. Can they get to the top? Dagger comes through right click from the blonde. They will draw first blood again. The Bronze Thug gonna be very happy with that one, especially because this is supposed to be a difficult lane. Laning a Magnus into a Dark Willow is just, you're gonna lose that harass war. So LeBron needed to make this play, but that's absolutely huge for them.
Rolling out.
He is. Chug, chug, chug. Meanwhile, Thug, Thug, Thug are gonna get jumped. Oh no, the spear drags him through the Bramble Maze. That hurts. And then we'll be able to bring him down. Beautifully timed by Boxy and Tiger to bring down the Phantom Assassin. It is non-stop action down here in this bottom lane as LeBron trying to trade up with Tiger. Tiger's gonna have a Bramble Maze available in a couple of seconds. LeBron's gonna be a little bit cautious. He will back himself away, trying to sidestep the Bramble Maze here. Oh, he walks into it though. Tiger, he's got the right click. The Shadow Remnant will be enough. He gets another. Thug coming in, looking for some revenge. I mean, he's got the Phantom Strike and another dagger available, but I'm not sure Boxy is going to let him have it with that spear available. Thug can't come forward, so they are just going to have to accept they've just lost two heroes in a row, thus tilting the lane back in Liquid's favor. Nope. Tiger's just styling. They are indeed. Meanwhile, over towards the middle lane, we've got Noob laning into Koigva. Visage, not a hero we've seen a lot of recently. It's fallen out of popularity pretty severely. Well, what's caused them to pick him up in this game?
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
We have DNZ drop in. Bloodseeker wants to finish the job onto Mika here, but with the South coming out, Mika is going to be able to sidestep the Blood right quite easily. Mitch, he needs to finish the job. Unfortunately, Zane is just bashing away at the back of him, throws in the Illuminate. One comes out from Mitch. Keeping in mind, but Mika's come back in. He's got the stun available in 2 seconds. Mitch could be in some real hot water right now as he goes up to that high ground, drops the Blood right, but Mika will be able to sidestep it easily and get a kill with the Storm Hammer in the process. Another disaster up in the top lane for the Spider Pigs.
Gonna be expecting this.
Now, I mean, he might go for the plus 25 movement speed at level 20. I'm just kidding. Yeah. So good.
Many thanks.
Exactly what you want.
All's fair.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I think Spen's gonna get a whole lot of touch in the next patch. I certainly hope so anyways, but not saying I don't enjoy some Superman Spen. We walk down to the bottom lane, we got a bit of action going on. They're trying to finish off the Dark Willow. She's pretty low on the side of Tiger. They're actually gonna get the cliff out onto Boxy. Throws him up the hill as they kill off Tiger. Forcing the TP out from the Mars. Well, they get some revenge. Some big revenge here, in fact, as they get themselves a kill and both the bounty runes, resulting in it's gonna be all four. They get all four bounty runes inside of Spider Pigs. Meanwhile, up at top, just a little bit of foreplay going on. Nothing extreme coming out in the top lane. They're just playing around with some spells. But yeah, Spider Pigs, they get themselves. I mean, this has been a wild laning phase so far. There's been so much trading going on, so much killing. Okay, he wasn't ready as they managed to get in with the Inks. Well, the stun will come off. Noobie's holding back on the top for the maximum amount of lockdown. Naked, though, he's not dead. He's actually trying to turn around to the Bloodseeker. Might be able to finish the job. Nope, never mind. Tree grab comes through, and they will take down the Spen. Big boy down. He's going to have to TP back in towards mid to defend his tower, though. In fact, DNZ is going to be the one to come through and try and stop Koi for doing too much damage to the tower. But him and his familiars are certainly getting to work here.
Dire are scanning.
Yeah, Quake was doing work already, but it's going to be interesting to see what he can do coming out into that early mid, especially with the advantage he's got in the middle lane as he is kind of rocking it so far. Noob not really getting much of a put in to this middle lane. I mean, he's getting fun. He's happy enough, and that rotation was pretty big as well. Maybe we'll see another one with the haste. Killing, Noob finds his haste rune, runs into the enemy jungle and finds a nice little kill onto the Coddle. Nice easy kill for the Tiny to bring down.
Look out for fallen
rocks!
Yeah, they are coming pretty deep here. I mean, they've got this arena. It looks like he really wants to throw down the arena of blood. Meanwhile, LeBron trying to hide in the trees, but gets spotted out and stunned up. Now looking for some revenge, though. Noob comes across. Arena defensively used by Boxy to try and help him get away, and he's going for the TP out, and he's going to be able to connect on that one. Unfortunately, Noob not quite in range for the avalanche, and it was still on cooldown as well. So a little bit interesting as Noob's rotation kind of gets wasted, but they're just plonking DNZ mid again. He does have to play very carefully into these familiars, but he's still getting a good amount of XP from this. And they get the Observer, and Noob gets a free kill. Wow.
Live on.
Oh my goodness, there's so much going on here. Koikva gets a kill at mid onto DNZ, gets him under the tower. You know, you gotta respect the familiars. Can't really blame them for falling once or twice there, because his hero is just so out of meta right now that you're probably not used to playing into it. But yeah, we'll just blast
Radiant's
you down if you
middle
call out.
Tower is under attack.
So what are these visitors' timings? It looks like, I mean, he's got a crown, he's got a Blightstone, could be going for anything at this point, has nothing queued up, he's keeping us guessing. What's your predictions on what Koipa's gonna build and how he's gonna play? Yeah.
Him doesn't even describe it!
You can get blood from a stone.
I'm gonna bot in, the kill on Tanoob is successful as they drop down with their spells. Tiger and Boxy just linking up together to bring down the Tiny. Yep, so those drums come out, and he's actually heading in towards a pipe pretty quickly. Interesting. We'll see how it works out. generally when we see visitors, you know, they tend to be very playing on map, just trying to make a lot of peace and push down some towers. Scanning. And then the team fights, you know, you're strong, and then you get that level 15 talent of Soul Assumption, hits two targets, and you become very, very strong. With the damage output there is just pretty insane.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, Noob's running in, really wants to find him. They gotta bring him down quickly, though. Lucky for them, so not too big of a threat, but it looks like Noob's gonna get it turned around upon now as the arena comes down. He'll get that kill. Rupture up from Boxy as he just chills inside his arena. Says, come at me, Noob. Do you wanna kill me? And now Mickey comes in from the side, popping the Godstrike, tearing DMZ apart. Stun's gonna land onto the Grimstroke as Mickey backs himself away. Doesn't wanna leash up to anyone. With that ultimate from the Grimstroke, will do so, but now it runs out. DMZ gonna get cut up by the Sven. Then we'll get the return kill onto Tigra. The Creep Dagger comes through from Thug. Thug now needs to leave. He can jump back to the Creep. Doesn't really wanna do so, there's a big red angry Mickey looking for him right now. The Slow's got to come out from the side. Is anybody coming to help him? There is Mitch. What can he do? Well, he can be a blink target. Will be that. Insane is ready. Misses with the Illuminate, but it looks like Thug will surely fall here as they catch him with the God's Rebuke, and a spear to the face will put an end to Thug. Meanwhile, LeBron tries to go for the charge back onto Mickey. Mickey doesn't care though. Insane now hitting level 6 and dropping down the left. But everyone else in the Sun Spider Pigs got to back themselves away. And it looks like this will be the end of this engagement. Or will it? This move's kind of looking forward. But surely this is done now. Surely this is all they can do.
Is under attack.
Interesting fight.
Bounty,
which my matriarch will prize.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's structures are fortified.
Yeah, Koifu's kind of just chilling. He's not interested in his engagements, which does really surprise me. I mean, I would have thought a visage would be very active. Meanwhile, Thug jumping up on top of his finger from the top lane. This guy has zero chill. He wants to bring down the big man on his horse once again here. But meanwhile, there's Marina in the back. That's going to catch out Boxy. On this Magnus, so Spider Pig's feeling very confident chasing for more as they chase back the side of Team Liquid. A lot of tempo on the side of Spider Pig, so they are here to fight, and they are doing exactly that as they drop that blink in. Sania just absolutely wrecked by Noob. Leveraging on the high ground, serving them very, very nicely as they bring down the obs.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Room plus the inks. Well, I mean, Tiger, good night. There he goes. The fairy is dead. Meanwhile, DMZ having some familiar problems, but Mitch is going to be able to take down one of them for a decent chunk of gold as they continue the aggression onto DMZ, and the spin is going to catch him and bring him down. Meanwhile, Noob, though, once more, another inks. Well, another kill. Gets it, but now he needs to get himself away. Going in towards the trees, going for the TP out. The familiar is going to be on top of him, though. Can they stand him in time? No, they cannot. A little bit slow from Koifa, and that's going to be a nice TP away for the Tiny as he gets himself to safety. And this whole time, the PH is just farming behind them with the Empower, just chilling, enjoying life.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Scanning.
Yeah, it seems to be pretty haphazard from Liquid, but it also feels like they're having a bit of fun here as well. They know that Mickey is still farming very, very well. He is the net worth leader, so they don't seem to be too worried about what's going to happen to them in the following minutes if they do end up messing up some fights. They view it as okay. Meanwhile, Insania, interestingly, is going for a Vanguard. Vanguard Kotl.
Dire's bottom tower is under
something
attack.
I'm familiar with. It's either Crimson or Abyssal. Abyssal Kotl. Here we go, kids. Strap yourselves in. See, jumping in, throws down the rear with the TNT emit from forcing distance and spins. It's coming really open here, but then with coming out big damage, going to make the block TNT. Mentions some trouble as well. Tiger's gonna chase him down. There is a rupture out, but they don't seem to care at all as they will be able to drop Mitch easily. And that's gonna be a nice couple of kills to the side of Liquid. To get out on the tiny, it seems, and meanwhile Thug's firing elsewhere very nicely, but at the same time, still two nice kills from Liquid, and it opens up a bit more of the map for them.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Yeah. Oh, Thug could be in some trouble. Boxy has himself and connects just about with the spear. I mean, that was close, but it does work. And now with the spear coming out onto PA, Tiger positions it perfectly, and that is going to be Thug brought down. That's an important one. Meanwhile, elsewhere, LeBron is having troubles. LeBron is going to come in and try and help him out here. Meanwhile, the X-Walker's dropped onto Mitch. Mitch is a little bit nervous about committing too hard to this one. Boxy comes in the back line. Another great spear coming down, pinning Mitch down in that little finger of death. Meanwhile, Grim, he's also going to get killed off by Mikke. Another two kills going the way of Liquid as they are kind of just taking over this map right now.
Radiant are scanning.
Oh no. The target has been found, and this one's going to be Noob as he is completely surrounded, turns around with the toss. It won't be enough to keep him alive, though. Although that said, Thug gets a kill elsewhere on the map, but could also be in some trouble himself. Thug gets on top of him. The RP is dropped from LeBron as they try to surround him. A nice little rail bug out from the... Nah, she's gone. She's gone. Thug gets a double, and even going to grab himself a nice little familiar, and also donating one towards the charity of DNC as well, so... Pretty good. PA gets a little bit whilst the tiny dies elsewhere on the map. Desolator PA could be an option.
Dire are scanning.
Fortunate drop the NATO, it's on 10 blood rush, gonna connect as well. They should be able to bring down and follow that. And then the Loveless, and then they're gonna bring him down. Big TNT's gonna die instead. Meanwhile, the Connor's still alive. Mitch really wants to come in and finish the job, but there's too much damage coming away from the dude. So if Boxy puts him out, kills him off, got a view, kind of spear, puts an end to him, and now Noob's gonna get stunned by the Curse Crown as well. Does have a blink dagger to get himself away. He listens to the Thug in the process, but doesn't do so as he moves in towards the trees. Liquid still chasing. Will he be able to find him is a question. He is duking them pretty nicely here. The whole team of Liquid giving chase, and they will not find him. But oh, they might have found someone else instead. LeBron, he's getting chopped up. See you later. Gets the spear off. Okay. Nice little skewer at the very last second. Gonna force Boxy to blink down from there, but with a blink dagger, it's still gonna be in a hole there. Life goes on, and now, oh no, Liquid, they are into that pit. They need to do something about this, but their big team fighter is dead. Into the pit, but they're just gonna drop down the Ignis Fighters on top of the Roshan to try and stop them jumping into it. They wanna try and give it a go, but the Roshan goes down. Mickey picks up the Aegis, now the Lips of Revenge. Oh, beautiful! Arena comes out from Boxy, cutting off Thug, and Mitch and DNZ will all fall together. Three heroes dead on the side of Spider Pig straight off the bat. Noob just trying to run himself away. They won't keep chasing the Tiny, I don't think, but still Liquid. They take Roshan, they take three heroes. Oh, Spider Pigs, you know, they look so good. They look so like. Excitable in game number one, and in game number two, they just seem to be falling apart of the seams here.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Yep, and you don't want to be giving those away, but at the same time, you can't turn up to the fights either. It's too damn scary, so really out of options here on the side of Spider Pig. They just got to try and play together. Hope they can make something magical happen, but That's looking like a bit of a pipe dream at this point. It's quite fair. That scary, scary visage coming through, layering on the stuns onto the Magnus. A spear from Boxy and a Gazuruk will finish him off. The Magnus gets dropped and another kill into the basket of Team Liquid as they take the bottom tower in the same time. Nice little drop from the Tiny. He's still able to do some stuff, especially Dyer's with the help of Grimstroke.
Follow me.
But unfortunately, it's not enough to give them much hope. And they might try and make a smoke of this. They certainly will. Noob, LeBron, DNZ, the little hope train coming out with the Radiant side of the map. Let's see if they can find anybody.
That's exact.
Yeah. In they go there. They're gonna find the nice little target kill. Once again, just going for the easy ones, but unfortunately there might be a bit of retribution now coming out from the Team Liquid as Boxy gets off that arena once again. They're trying to make some sort of play on the side of Spider-Man. There's nothing to be done. Mikkei's gonna jump in and cleanly kill off Noob as DNZ gets killed by Quickba. Liquid now looking forward for more, but I mean, Spider-Pig just leaving. They are just gone, but that's it for me. It's controlling up Magnus. Another great spear from Boxy. The Blood Rider is down. He's gonna stop him. You betcha not. Mikkei comes in, finishes off the kill. Looking towards the tier 2 tower, look at how quickly it goes down. My goodness, it's Radiant's pushing power from Liquid. They might be knocking on the high ground right now. They
Radiant's
certainly
middle
are.
Tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. Dire structures are fortified.
It's a sad time to be a pig. But down here, yeah, there we go. They get the kill onto the visage with relative ease. And Spider Pigs, well, I mean, they're going to be able to take over a bit of this. Also, that Aegis timer. No, she's got to avoid the Sven, like, at all costs in the next fight. Otherwise, she will just get slapped down into oblivion. Meanwhile, Insania, I mean, he's just farming. Like, he's just playing the farming five. Loving life, heading towards the solar crest at an alarming rate. He's actually got more CS than the Tiny does. 93 on the, or 97 now, on the Coral versus the 81 on his Tiny, because, you know, he's just been killing. Tiny's just been looking to make kills, make space, get heroes, and ignore the farm. Yes.
Dire are scanning. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Feels rather likely. You see, helping out Sven quite a lot. You know, the one way which Sven is going to die in these fights, if he's caught without Warcry by the PA with her anti-armor, he will die very quickly if that's the case, but doing so is very, very difficult. And without 15 armor from Warcry up, they're not going to be able to bring him down, and the AC is going to help mitigate that massively as well. Meanwhile, they're jumping Insania at mid. I mean, this is a very rich Connor. They will be able to bring him down, but now Liquid's coming in. They're looking for revenge. Arena is perfect. Also both Thug and Tiny, and now the V comes in on top. They've already taken down Thug, and Tiny blasts his face into the the side of the arena, gets brutally killed, and now they get on top of the Bloodseeker as well. Superman comes flying on through, scoops up another kill, and Mickey and his big fat sword take down three heroes. DNZ on the run, they might not be done here as DNZ gets netted up, and in he comes. Mickey comes through, gets himself the ultra. Mitch is gonna run himself away. He should be okay. Oh my god, what am I talking about? It's Ben. Of course, I'm okay. Let's skewer back into the fountain. Mickey's better one. He can shoot. He's gonna die. RP gets used, but does not connect as they try to run themselves away. But this could be really bad for the side of Liquid. They might have been number one Mikachu. Boxy going for the TP away. Tiger won't be so lucky as he gets killed, but Boxy will get himself out. Meanwhile, Coif was just trying to deal with the buildings, trying to play some objective-based gameplay, but LeBron's coming through with that skewer, trying to find him, trying to bring him down. Does have a shockwave to drag him back in a little bit. Coif was trying to turn it around, but there's a room coming out from Mick with the Blood Rite coming out on top of him as well. Insania coming back into the mix. He's got an ultimate, so they should both get themselves away here. I doubt there's much more chasing they can really do. LeBron trying to go for the skewer play, though. Does manage to grab out Coif, but Insania sighs and says, fine, I'll drop my ultimate down, and new Blink Dagger is going to get caught out by Insania's Blinding Light as well. Doing a lot of work in this cuddle to cover the retreat of the Coifer, and it does look like they will be able to get themselves to safety.
What a bounty! I must have them all!
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Yeah.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Liquid are invading here, but they've got a double damage bottled up and ready to go on the PF. She can get off her BKB. She can do serious work in the fight. We're going to trouble Blur as they jump forward onto Mitch. Mitch's going to be the main target here. Meanwhile, the Yule comes out onto the fence and Assassin. She pops to the feet of the BKB, turns it around with double damage, but Boxy, he just doesn't care. He puts up his shield and just ignores her. Thug's entire BKB duration is going to get completely wasted. This wasn't the game plan at all. In fact, she puts the DD before she got Yule to the Yule and just got curved immediately. Oh no, that is just tragic. And well, Moon is gonna join this PA in death here as another unit comes down, and when he comes back to the earth, he's gonna get taken down very, very quickly. So Nick is running circles, doesn't even feel the need to slap it in, as Moon is gonna fall. Nick moves into a tier 1 tower, but this game may well just be over here.
Radiant's middle barracks has fallen.
Take away the temptation. Oh wow. Yeah, that's what Radiant's I was just saying. He used it before his BKB, so sad. Boxy. He's very wise to Magnus' shenanigans. Mag once again, trying to go for the skewer back, gonna get punished for it as he gets taken down. Flyback is available to Mag, they'll have everybody else available to fight in 2 seconds, so if they want to buy back to the Mag, that is. Let's see what they can do here. Same here, buddy. Okay, well, that was a bit suicidal. He's fighting with a man down now. The 5 versus 4. And they're actually gonna get chased away here. And I was saying that. Mag's gonna get, the Boxy's gonna get left behind. He throws down the arena, does miss the spear onto the BKB PA. So he's just gonna try and moonwalk his way out of this situation, but unfortunately, he can't be saved from that. Coifer, meanwhile, he's having some fun. He jumps into the front line, throwing down a couple of soul assumptions onto the heroes here. Tiny's getting peppered, and now in comes his fan. Beautiful RP, but unfortunately, a beautiful lurk. Peter from Tiger is gonna completely defuse the situation as Mitch is gonna get killed off. Sven just ripping through everybody, one hero at a time. Thug's gonna die, LeBron's gonna follow. Now we'll get the ultra kill on the Sven. No rampage, but who needs it when you've got a game instead? And the series will go to Team Liquid.